Hello for Monday, July 30th. We've got two more days of trading this month, so can we have a little continuation of that window dressing that started Friday? Maybe on Monday. We are up to some resistance levels and a bit overbought. Anyway, look at all the market charts. We got a lot of them in the weekend newsletter, stocktiger.net, upper top right-hand corner. You can see them all there. We've got a few additions to the watch list. We had a ton of them. What were the 8 or 9 or so broke out on Friday? Some very good gains. More in a single day than we've had in quite some time. Another biotech here up about over 50% since that low in early June. Looks good. All the moving averages, of course, the ribbon crossed in the beginning of July. Looks like everything's in order for it to break out again higher over about $4.73. Of course, we'd like to see good volume. The good volume makes it more likely that we're going to advance even higher. CFX over $30.40 is the level. We've got all that resistance back in April and May, as you can see there, and it is getting above the top Bollinger Band. But we'd like the improved volume as it moves up, and then lower volume as it consolidates. So this may has to rest a while here before it breaks out over that $33, $40 area. But it looks pretty good at the moment. FOSL coming up. 77.50 looks like the spot. Look, it's showing the 50-day EMA there. It's 76.63. So it could be above there. We've got the line drawn from where the high was after it dipped in July. It was higher in June. It was up 77.60, then 77.50. So you can see somewhere above that first line could then run up to the 81.30 area. That's where the high was after the big drop down. And then if that got going, eventually maybe to 92, testing that gap and also the 200-day EMA. We'd like to see some more volume. It did have improving volume, 1.7 million shares passed hands on Friday. INFA looks pretty interesting. Back over about that 32. It broke into the gap slightly, went above the 20-day moving average, which is at 32.14. So we're saying back over 32 with good volume. It'd be nice really if it pulled back for a while. Maybe it went down as low as 29, 29.50, somewhere in there, and then set up for a big move higher. It's got two gap ups. That's what we don't like. But if it does trigger, watch where it goes and take some profits, of course. We always like to do it the first day, particularly on ones like that. MDT looks interesting, over 39.12. Had a good move up on Friday. It's not a wonderful setup in that it's not any clean space. We've got all that March and early April to deal with, and then the February. But we think we could get up to the 40 area again and maybe above the second line as well. So if you like this price range, look for possible momentum movement above that first area. And then SNTA above about $7.80. with resistance up to that high of $8.50. It is over the top Bollinger Band. Improving volume looks pretty good. Would like it to go sideways for a couple days first, but hey, it is what it is. It looks pretty good. So that's what we have anyway for additions on for Monday. Hope you have a great trading day. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll send tweets out before the market opens and during the day as well. So other than that, we'll see you again on Monday night with some new ideas in Market Wrap at that time. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.